This woman put $50,000 into her dress when this one put $100. These three women stole money from a bank. However, the amount they stole is used money. This place is the bank of the U.S. Federal Reserve. Every day, this place contains millions of dollars of used money, which are delivered there and demolished as rubbishes. Looking at these coins being crushed, Bridge Cardigan gasps in shock. Today is her first working day at this place as a cleaner. The leader told her that in addition to cleaning duties, she is also responsible for cleaning all the pieces of demolished notes. That witnessing a huge amount of money makes people unable to stand their desires. Rather, Bridget's husband has just been unemployed and they are owing a big amount. However, the security of this place is so strict. From the classification to delivery, to the crushing process, each step is observed by cameras. The most important thing is the key to the delivery truck. There are only three keys. They are allocated to three departments: classified, finance, and demolished. And the ones who are responsible for them must only work in their areas. Even when they go to the toilet, they have a guard to manage and calculate timing. But Bridge supposes that when humans still exist, no security system is perfect. One day, when going to the supermarket, Bridget finds out that a key on the shelf is likely the key of the delivery truck. Suddenly, a daring thought popped into her head. And then, during the cleaning time, she silently observes the cameras. 20 days later, finally, in a corner of the elevator, Bridget discovered a dead corner of the camera. Then while working, she intentionally dropped the $10 note. Then asked the colleague nearby if he dropped it. This person picked it up and said no and also said that he had to hand it over. Bridget must find two more accomplices. She targets Nina, a woman in charge of daily money destruction. But when Bridget said his intention to steal his money, the hungry side immediately refused. Because Nina is a single mother, if she gets caught, her two children will be sent to an orphanage. Bridget realizes that kids are Nina's weakness. The next day, in Nina's closet, there were flyers about prestigious schools. What is good for their children? Perhaps no mothers can refuse. Nina then agreed. Finally, they found the person in charge of the money transfer is Jackie. Jackie has been diabetic since her childhood. The amount of money for treatment for a long time left her exhausted. Three like-minded people meet. They go for a signal. It's to touch the eyebrows. Bridget put the key she bought at the supermarket and put it on her belt and smoothly passed the security door. Everything was ready. At noon of that day, Nina and Bridget gave a signal to confirm the action. But Jackie suddenly shook her head. When she went to the toilet, she had a bad feeling about today. Both Nina and Bridget didn't know what to say. Nina angrily announced their disbandment. Then, while going through the security check when leaving, the bank manager appeared. They have a sudden full body check today. All of them breathed a sigh of relief and felt so lucky. The next day, the three women once again stroke their eyebrows. The official plan begins. While Bridget is cleaning, she silently replaced the lock on the money truck with the one she bought at the supermarket. After that, she tells the car number to Jackie. Jackie is in charge of transferring money. While waiting for the elevator, Jackie will use the car to cover his body, then use the key that Bridget gave her earlier, open the car door, quickly grab a few pieces of money, and throw it in the trash behind. And all of this, the security guard did not find out at all. Even though these are bills to be destroyed, the quantity is fixed. Bridget then takes the original key and puts it in the trash can in the toilet. And Nina, while destroying the money, will take the opportunity to exchange the lock. And then all remaining funds will be destroyed. No one found out that there was a shortage of money. At the same time, Bridget will treat the stolen money as garbage and collect it. After the work is done, they will meet in the bathroom, putting the stolen money inside their clothing. When they check out, normally no one will check security on their bodies. After returning home, they started counting money. The first amount they stole $90,000. In the days after, the three women continued their plans. But not long after, they ran into a big problem. Because the amount of money is too much, there is no room in their house to store it. So they had to dig a hole to bury the money. Then seeing that everything was enough, Nina and Bridget's husband decided not to do it anymore. But Bridget and Jackie definitely disagree. The fascination of money is so huge. Since then, they seem not to collaborate as well as they used to. One day, Bridget threw the key to Nina, accidentally dropping it in the water pipe. The only spare key is in Jackie's hand. To avoid suspicion, they do not save each other's phone numbers. Bridget immediately called her husband, then asked him to inform Jackie's husband. When there is no duty to transfer money, Jackie is not allowed to go down to the destruction room. And Nina here is going to have to destroy the next money truck. If she can't open that lock, everything will be revealed. Jackie was quick-witted. She pretended to argue with others, then stuck the key on the gum, and stuck it on the elevator. Bridget was cleaning downstairs, so she took the opportunity of clearing away the gum. When she reaches the destruction room, the security guard is helping Nina to unlock. At that time, the security guard thought the lock was broken. Bridget quickly distracted the guard, then threw the key to Nina. The danger is over, but unexpectedly, the security guy still noticed everything. Barry didn't tell his superiors, because he is secretly in love with Nina. Then Nina immediately dressed up, started negotiating with Barry. They officially date then. Now from the sorting room to the destruction room, from security guards to cleaning staff, every stage has their own people. The people are more reckless. But not long after, their life seemed ostentatious. Drew the attention of the people of the Federal Bureau of Investigation. Bridget realized the problem, but it was too late. The next day, the investigator went to the bank and gave out pictures of the three people's lavish lives, but the director does not admit it. He has great confidence in the bank's security system, so immediately fired the investigator. At the same time, Bridget's husband found out they were under surveillance. The people decided to destroy all the exhibits. Nina burned all the money. Bridget's husband tore them up and flushed them down the toilet. Jackie and his wife blew up the mobile garage containing their money. But unfortunately, the police showed up, and all of you were arrested. Fortunately, Bridget brought a large bag of money, ran to the trunk and escaped. After a night of interrogation, Jackie confessed all the blame on himself, on the condition that Nina be found innocent and released immediately, because she still has children. However, at this time, Bridget brings a lawyer there, because the investigator had no clues that this money was stolen from the bank. The bank manager also knew that these three women stole money, but he didn't dare admit it, because he knew that he couldn't bear the consequences at all. The tax man said, even though the money was not stolen by them, they haven't paid it yet, so they still have to pay the fine. They were eventually released, but all their possessions were confiscated. They go back to the lives of the poor. 8 months later, Bridget asked Nina and Jackie to go to the bar they used to go to. It's because Bridget's mom used to tell her, never put all your eggs in one basket. Bridget soon knew everything was going to be revealed, so every time she steals money, she takes out some money and keeps it in this bar. Seeing the room full of money, the three women were extremely excited.